Hello, how y'all doing? It's me, Epiphany of Truth, aka Gregory Brown, here with my man Gary. You know what I mean? Artist Recreates the World, and this is the part two segment. And we're gonna talk more about my history growing up here in Newark. So many of you may not know, I was born with fluid on my brain, underdeveloped lungs, and actually unfortunately born to a mother who was a crackhead, which later, you know, created pretty much a delay in my learning. But I overcame a lot of that. Pretty much, I had dyslexia growing up, so reading, I read everything kind of screwed up and got everything mixed up. What else? My parents died when I was young. So writing became my way of expressing my frustrations and anger. I had got away from it at one point. Started trying other talents. Did a little bit of singing when I grew up. Played some guitar and piano.
Oh, you still did some singing. You did some singing last year.
Yeah. I mean, still do a little bit of singing. I really want to get coached on honing the power of my voice in that perspective, because it's a lot different from spoken word, you know. More about me. I'm currently 27. I'll be 28 December 6th.
Capricorn?
Sag. All day, baby. All day. Don't even play, man. Sag all day.
So how has that battle been? You know, when people told you you had this and your situation. Did you always feel in your heart that you had something to give people? Did you always feel in your heart? I mean, even before you knew you were a writer, did you know there was more for you? Because, I mean, that's more than a great story, because people that listen to this, you know, they have stuff that they go through, whether it be family situations, emotional situations,
physical situations. Well, I grew up, man, I did know this. I knew that there had to be more. I mean, I came from pretty much a meaningless system that didn't really care about the outcome of my well-being, whether I became a statistic or stuff like that. And so, being that I had to come up through, you know, being abused and child molestation and even rape, and being left for dead in a dumpster. I don't really share those stories because, you know, it's not some open, everyday open conversation. We don't really share that. But I feel like people need to know that, you know, that there are people out there who are striving to better themselves despite what they went through in their childhood, you know. That I'm not letting it get the best of me or be a handicap. When I was younger, they wanted to label me everything under the sun, you know, tried to, you know, say I was emotionally disturbed, when all I really needed was love, you know, and a sense of belonging, like, you know, being cared for. They wanted to label me bipolar because they thought, you know, they just thought they could hold me down and put me into a box, and prove to them, you know, that I wanted a life of my own. Like, right before I got out of the child care system and the state dropped my case as being a board of state, I made sure, because usually when you get 18, they drop your case or whatever, they hand you your last little check for like $200-$300 or whatever the case may be, and then that's it. I made them hold my case for another 4.5 years, till I was damn near pushing 22. And I made sure they gave me my independence, you know, gave me an apartment, you know, gave me my own place and gave me my own voucher, so that way I could be able to have a chance to strive and make it and make a life for myself, you know?
And get to a point where you're at now. You know what? I hear you saying that it's so, I mean, a lot of stuff is so powerful about your story. But what I hear you saying is that those innate skills as an artist that were in you, that you were born with, almost came out through everything, regardless. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like, if you were born an artist, it doesn't matter. The circumstances don't even matter. All you need is the ability to live from moment to moment, because those gifts are going to come. They're going to surface. They're going to manifest themselves. That's a powerful story for people to understand.
Oh, I'm only skimming the surface.
I'm sure you are. I'm glad, because you know I only have. No.
Through all that, where I'm at now, you know.
You're giving us the edited version.
Yeah, giving you the edited version. So where I'm at now, I'm still on my own or whatever. I'm living with I have a friend as a roommate. So I'm maintaining that right now. I'm in the process of working on my book, which has been a long time coming. I sort of dragged my feet. Actually, the person that told me I needed to write a book was first one of my best friends, the poetry people out there, out circuit shit knowing, Jahan De La Cruz. We used to be boys, we used to be real tight, and his name was Chaos, Chaos One, in the poetry circuit. And basically, he we used to always hang out. He inspired my writing. He inspired me to write my own book. Jay Skills, Elijah Brown.
Somehow I knew you were gonna say Elijah Brown.
So yeah, Elijah Brown. You know what I mean, he's been a big influence. I was just one that I kept dragging my feet about it, only because I felt like the book wasn't really gonna be a success. But how could you? You know, doubt whether how successful your book is going to be if you don't write it. So this is me finally putting it into action. The name of my book, when it's finally published, is going to be The Journey and Evolution of a Writer. And it's going to be a book of poems and a little bit of my story, a little bit of my story as a writer.
That's a nice mix. It's different.
Yeah, I get them two sides, you know. Go easy on them.
Another edited version? Or that's going to be
another edited version.
Yeah.
I'm going to give y'all one more poem before we close out.
He done took over my YouTube channel. He's just telling us when we're doing poems there.
Yeah, basically. I'm going to hit y'all with one more poem before we close out this little segment we got going. And this speaks about my journey, pretty much. It's a poem / rap, pretty much. But it really speaks to my journey. No title for it, but here it goes. Drowning in a world full of anger, overdosed on life full of danger, stuffed in a world full of false hope, tired of a life full of dope, kicked in a world full of pain, trapped in a life full of games, pushed in a world full of negativity, exposed to a life full of bad activities, burned in a world full of lies, paralyzed in a life full of good vibes, frozen in a world of defeat, mocked in a life full of deceit, thrown in a world full of corrupted history, hated in a life full of misery, molded in a world full of rumors and publications, laughed at in a life full of minimum education, clown in the world made for you decline, shift in a life trying to climb, ignore.
Oh, go ahead, keep going.
Ignored in the world full of dreams, spit on in a life full of failing, held up in a life full of nailing, robbed in a world full of good deeds, killed in a life of things that shouldn't be.
Peace. McLean, doing your thing, man. Thank you again.
You know, doing your thing. Marjorie creates the world, baby. You know.
Oh, we like that. Peace.
Peace.